To the students in the room, raise your hand if you've ever used generative AI, like ChatGPT, to help you write an assignment. Come on now, don't be shy. Your professors aren't in the room. Hopefully. I definitely have. Generative AI is the single most powerful learning tool I've ever used. It's my 24/7 tutor, my eagle-eyed proofreader, and my favorite brainstorming tool. I'm not alone. In a survey of over 800 university students, more than half of them said generative AI had helped them get better grades. But I'm also not alone in being confused by universities' generative AI policies. Students are often unsure if they can use generative AI, and more importantly, how much AI use is allowed. In my short time at university, I've completed 8 different units, and every single unit has had a different generative AI directive. So that meant that every single time I sat down to write an assignment, I grappled with one annoyingly complicated question. Is using generative AI cheating? And am I doing it? 60% of university students are worried about being accused of cheating with generative AI. The rules surrounding AI use are constantly changing and are inconsistent within educational institutions. I have 2 units where I'm learning to code in the same programming language. In one unit, all AI use is allowed. In the other, none at all. It just doesn't make sense. Universities need to provide a clear and nuanced definition of acceptable generative AI use. Students like me are bearing the consequences of enforcing vague and often nonsensical policies. The AI detection software used by universities are unreliable and rarely accurate. These tools are unable to definitively prove AI plagiarism and do not provide clear justification for flagging students' work. They also discriminate against non-native English speakers, falsely identifying their work as AI-generated at far higher rates than their peers. In a Stanford study, 60% of non-native English speakers' essays were misclassified as AI-generated. The ethical debate about how we use AI is at the forefront of policy conversations, and that's great. We absolutely need to be having those discussions, but the equally important ethical problems of generative AI policing appear to be largely ignored. Universities have an imperative to provide for their students and provide clarity around the use of generative AI. AI detection software used by universities is not yet reliable enough to provide a one-size-fits-all solution or to detect users who engage with this technology in the wrong way. And when universities apply a slew of different policies against different faculties, subjects, and disciplines, students are left to fend for themselves on an uneven and inequitable playing field. So, how do we fix AI detection? That's the wrong question to ask. It's the easy question, the one that pops right into your head, the, oh, okay, we've got a problem, what's the solution type question? Consider, what if we stopped focusing on detecting AI use and started focusing on designing AI use? Students subverting assessment design and learning objectives isn't a detection problem, it's a design problem. Generative AI is such an incredibly powerful, innovative, and accessible tool that needs to be fully embraced by educational institutions. So how do we design the ways students learn and are assessed with AI in mind? Well, the first thing we need to do is change our AI vocabulary. Terms like AI plagiarism and detection should be replaced with responsible AI use and design. This might look like adopting a generative AI policy framework that sits separately to plagiarism in university policy documents. The time for a nuanced discussion that accepts the place of generative AI in universities is now. There are undoubtedly risks to AI adoption, bias, and an over-reliance on these tools, to name a few. But students need to learn how to use AI responsibly and ethically. Students will soon enter workplaces where AI use is expected. The ability to use AI effectively and mitigate its risks are quickly becoming key skills. Just as proficiency in Microsoft Office became expected, so too will proficiency in generative AI. If not in universities, then where will students learn these skills? To design the ways universities adopt generative AI technologies, we need a variety of perspectives. Not just students and teachers, but industry groups, employers, businesses using AI, and ethicists. Reframing AI use from a detection problem to a design problem allows us to broaden the discussion and include a more diverse array of perspectives. By accepting AI use as a design problem, we can foreground voices discussing the ethics of AI, 21st century skills, and future-ready education. The ways in which we decide to use AI now will shape our world in the coming years. Universities have been presented with this incredible opportunity to shape the way we interact with and use generative AI. So, I have good news for you guys today. These conversations and the reframing of generative AI use are already happening right here in Australia. Monash University has developed an excellent framework for this discussion based on three questions. One, does the assessment need to change? Two, how can we design AI into the assessment? And three, how can we design AI out? The order of these questions is really important. When undertaking this redesign process, we first need to reevaluate the skills being assessed. Being a human is about more than passing a CAPTCHA test. It's about creativity, critical thinking, and empathy. These uniquely human skills should be the focus of university in an era of rapidly moving technological change. After critically evaluating the subject matter of our assignments, we then need to focus on bringing AI in. Only then do we answer the question of how to design AI out. Designing AI out of an assessment means creating tasks generative AI can't do. For example, asking a student to verbally explain their reasoning to a teacher to ensure they understand key concepts. As we attempt to design a future-ready higher education system, opting out of new technology should be the exception, not the norm. So let's have a quick think about what this actually looks like in an essay. For example, generative AI could be used to brainstorm ideas, scaffold responses, help students find those words they just can't quite remember, rewrite paragraphs, proofread, and so much more. It can do the grunt work for students, giving them more time to express their creativity and critical thinking. But it could also write the entire thing for them. So our assessments need to become more holistic, designing AI out, where necessary, to prove that students have a deep understanding of subject matter. This might look like assessing students on their verbal reasoning, thought processes, or engagement in peer debate. We can let AI write for us, but we can't let AI think for us. The challenge of adopting new technology isn't new. From typewriters to calculators, the internet, and now generative AI, change is the one constant. Universities have been presented with this incredible opportunity to shape the way we interact with and use generative AI by creating an environment where AI use is accepted, integrated, and perhaps even encouraged. We can create, collaborate, and inform how these frameworks are designed if we work together. We can lobby universities to redesign themselves for the age of AI. And when they ask for our perspectives in surveys, panels, and forums, we can and have to answer. Student voices need to be heard. Redesigning higher education for the age of AI won't be easy, but plainly, it is the only option we have that allows students to survive and thrive in a rapidly changing world. Thank you.